In 2018, Netflix announced the Avatar: Last Airbender live adaptation to the excitement of many, including myself. And in June of 2020, we actually saw Atla get a full release of the original series on the platform, which was incredible. I, for one, definitely hopped on the bandwagon as fast as possible once I saw that Netflix had released the original series onto their platform. And I sat down to cry at another rendition of Leaves from the Vine. It was not pretty.
Little soldier boy comes marching home. Brave soldier boy.
I'd really love to get into Korra since Netflix is planning to release that fairly soon. In fact, I think as of this video, it was actually released on August 14th. So as of this video, it's already been released onto the platform as far as I remember. Being that there's such a separation between Atla fans and Korra fans, I'd really rather not get into that here and probably make a separate video for Korra because Korra kind of deserves it. Both the creators have decided that they are no longer wanting to be involved in the live adaptation for the series on Netflix, and that is incredibly unfortunate. And Michael Dante DiMartino actually wrote an open letter, which is right here, on August 12th to all of the fans. And it reads like this: "Many of you have been asking me for updates about the Avatar live-action Netflix series. I can finally tell you that I'm no longer involved with the project. In June of this year, after 2 years of development work, Brian Konietzko and I made the difficult decision to leave the production. When Brian and I signed on to the project in 2018, we were hired as executive producers and showrunners. In a joint announcement for the series, Netflix said that it was committed to honoring our vision for this retelling and to support us on creating the series. And we expressed how excited we were for the opportunity to be at the helm. Unfortunately, things did not go as we had hoped. Look, things happen, productions are challenging, unforeseen events arise, plans have to change. And when those things have happened at any other points of my career, I try to be like an air nomad and adapt. I do my best to go with the flow no matter what obstacle is put in my way, but even an air nomad knows when it's time to cut their losses and move on. I started to reevaluate what is truly important in my life and what I wanted to do with what's left of it. I took some advice from Uncle Iroh. I looked inward and started asking myself the big question: who are you and what do you want? I also sought wisdom from the Stoic philosophers who were big on differentiating between what is within our control and what isn't. I realized I couldn't control the creative direction of the series, but I could control how I responded. So I chose to leave the project. It was the hardest professional decision I've ever had to make, and certainly not one that I took lightly. But it was necessary for my happiness and creative integrity. And who knows? Netflix's live adaptation of Avatar has the potential to be good. It might turn out to be a show many of you end up enjoying. But what I can be certain about is that whatever version ends up on the screen will not be what Brian and I had envisioned or intended to make. I also want to be clear that this does not mean the end of my involvement in the Avatar universe. These stories and characters are important to me, and the renewed interest and excitement in Avatar and Korra have been inspiring to see. Writing this letter has left me with a very heavy heart. I know many of you will be disappointed and frustrated by this news. I get it. I share your disappointment and frustration. I also recognize this creative setback is small compared to the problems we're facing as a society right now. Thankfully, Iroh has offered some wisdom in that too. Sometimes life is like this dark tunnel. You can't always see the light at the end of the tunnel, but if you just keep moving, you will come to a better place. May we all keep moving and come to a better place. Thanks for reading and for your continued enthusiasm for the Avatar universe. With gratitude, Michael Dante DiMartino." As unfortunate as all this is, I know there's going to be a huge outcry from fans that are going to take a chance to shoot this down at every opportunity. And it's just the way that things go now. While I'm not saying that all of it isn't wholly deserved, I feel the cancel culture kind of berates things that really deserve a chance to breathe, at least for a little bit. I'd really rather not piss off the whole fandom and cancel culture and their respective ideologies, but with this announcement, it's kind of hard not to feel disheartened and want to reject the project as it currently is. I feel that the creators also kind of wanted to exude a little bit of that sentiment in their posts, that they did not want people to hate the series before it comes out, no matter how much it may hurt for them to leave after 2 years of work. I just feel like they still love the idea of Avatar getting a brand new reboot. However, being that it wasn't in their vision, obviously they had to step back and say that this is not what they had intended. I'm not going to say that I'm going to be part of the crowd that isn't looking forward to the series as much anymore, but I'm definitely not going to be a part that's going to boycott it, because I've already seen so much of Twitter basically like shit on this whole thing already, and it's really, really shitty to see. I understand that something like this puts a huge damper on the hype for such an ambitious project that so many people love and appreciate, but not letting it live first is the whole problem with cancel culture and the low expectations. When you're already determined to hate something, there's literally no room in your life to let it exist as it is. I'm gonna go into this with like a moderate temperament and hope that it's not gonna be butchered to extinction. We'll just really have to wait and see and hope that Netflix decides to give the same love as it did to The Witcher and Sabrina, because very obviously Netflix has had some really, really good live adaptations of stuff. I'm not gonna get my hopes up, but I am pretty excited to see where this is gonna end up going. With Netflix already at the epicenter of all these brand new shows that are coming out that are just incredible, I can't see why Avatar would be one of the ones that they ended up flopping on. It's already got an original series attached to it with all of the source content. I don't see how it could possibly diverge from what it's supposed to be. Obviously, the creators weren't able to let their visions be true, but it could still be a good thing. You get to basically relive the series in a new platform, and even if it doesn't end up, you know, living up to the same standards as the original series, which more than likely it's not going to, because there's some sort of nostalgic factor that has to deal with that. It's an older show that you grew up watching, more than likely. So all these new people that are coming into the fandom and are able to see the original series, or if they come in during the live action series and they only experience that, that's just more people getting together to enjoy one thing. And that's basically what it's about. You know, you introduce these new people to this new series for them. They get to live it as we had the first time that we saw Avatar The Last Airbender air on Nickelodeon. I feel like I've pretty much said all I wanted to on the subject. There's a lot that I could really get into, and a lot more that I feel like I could probably say. But it's pretty much all going to be the same thing. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you would like to discuss it down in the comments below, please do leave a comment and let me know what you think about this. I'm probably going to end up doing a series of sorts on Avatar The Last Airbender and a lot of the things that I like about it and a lot of things that I hate about it. I'm also planning on doing a kind of review thing once the live adaptation does come out, because I'd really, really like to give my thoughts on the series, especially compared to the original series. So, again, thank you for watching. I really, really appreciate it. We'll see you guys in the next one. Good later.